Last week I published a video about how easy it is to create Dolby Atmos with Fiedler Audio's Dolby Atmos Composer within the machine ecosystem. It's one of my favorite videos so far, and if you have not seen that yet, I'll leave a link in the description. Check it out. I had so much fun creating this video that I decided to make a follow-up video. In this video, we're going to take our Dolby Atmos machine setup one step further. We will explore how to use Fiedler Audio's Spatial Reverb Spacelab to add a fully immersive reverb. And on top of that, we will also look into how to use Fiedler Audio's multi-channel dynamics plugin Gravitas for fully immersive sidechaining. So without further ado, let's jump into more immersive machine madness. So let's jump into our machine setup, and as last week, I'm going to use one of the sessions that come with the factory selection of machine. Let's just have a listen what we have here. It's essentially a relatively straightforward groove. And what we're going to do is we're going to turn that into Dolby Atmos, and then we're going to work with Spacelab to add a little bit of an immersive reverb, and then we're going to work with Gravitas in order to sidechain the reverb to the kick. That's essentially what we're going to do. Now, the initial Dolby Atmos setup, I'm just going to go through that. If you want to know the details, I recommend that you watch my last week's video. Here, I'm just going to go through the steps relatively quickly, but nevertheless, you should be able to follow if you have some idea about how Dolby Atmos works. The first thing that we need to do is we need to put the Dolby Atmos composer onto our master track, onto our master bus, and so we are going to click on master here, and we're simply going to add the Fiedler Audio Dolby Atmos Composer. Now this will essentially be the plugin that is responsible for turning everything into Dolby Atmos, and once again, if you've done that, you know the drill. There are 128 channels. The first 10 channels are the Dolby Atmos bed, and then the remaining 118 channels are the Dolby Atmos objects. Now, in order to get Dolby Atmos objects into the Dolby Atmos Composer, what we need is we need to route individual sounds or groups into the Dolby Atmos Composer via the Dolby Atmos Beam plugin. Because if you play the sound right now, nothing is actually going to really sound, simply because everything is just blocked by the Dolby Atmos Composer. We need to route the sounds explicitly. So the first thing that we're going to do is the same thing that we also did last week, and that is we're going to route the kick as an object. So let me just go into the sound section, and for the first group, the kick, essentially, let's just route that into the Dolby Atmos Composer via the Fiedler Audio Dolby Atmos Beam plugin. If I put that in, I see here the controls for the individual objects, which essentially are two objects, a left channel, a right channel. These are two objects. Azimuth elevation distance, we have the spread, which kind of defines the size of those objects, and the volume knob. If we play that now, we should hear something. And the reason we hear that is if we go into the master again and we open up the Dolby Atmos Composer, we essentially see that the kick is coming in here. It's currently set to 9.1.6, which for me is the default. I'm usually using that as the standard composite in the Dolby Atmos Composer. Once again, a composite is a generalization of a Dolby Atmos bed that goes beyond the limitation of 7.1.2. What I want to do here is really kind of turn it into an object. So I'm simply going to set that to object, and that will then essentially turn it into two objects, really 11 and 12. Now I could go into the Dolby Atmos Beam plugin, and that is actually in this particular application might actually not be a bad idea. I'm just not going to do that here because it's not necessary, but depending on how you want to work, you can actually do that. You could turn that into a mono object, because once again, it's just a kick. So this is technically actually a mono object, but I'm going to leave it in stereo just because. So now the next thing I want to do is I want to route the group number one into the Dolby Atmos Composer. And the way we did that last week is that we used another Beam plugin in order to route that. This time I'm going to do it differently, because I want to route that not only as a dry signal, I also want to give it an immersive reverb with the Spacelab reverb. And in order to do that, I need to add Spacelab to our setup. And if you have worked with the Fiedel Audio, Dolby Atmos Composer and Spacelab, you know that this is usually done on a separate audio track in your digital audio workstation. In Ableton, for example, I usually use a return track for the purpose. Now, in Machine, you don't really have that. Now, we need to put it somewhere. So what I'm going to do is I'm simply going to add an additional group, and this is going to become an empty group. And the only purpose of this group is really to hold the Spacelab reverb. And what I'm going to do here is simply going to add the Spacelab reverb. So once again, Fiedler Audio, VST3, where we have Fiedler Audio here, Spacelab. I'm working with Spacelab Interstellar. Spacelab comes in two versions, like the Dolby Atmos Composer, Interstellar, and Ignition. Unfortunately, neither of those is free, so I actually have to purchase them. But they both work. In my case, I'm going to use the big version, which is Interstellar, but the Ignition version is perfectly fine. So I'm going to add that here. This will essentially add Spacelab to this empty group. And this empty group is sort of is going to take on the responsibilities almost of like a return track for us. So what we're going to do is we're going to route the groove number one into the Spacelab plugin, and Spacelab will then route it into the Dolby Atmos Composer. So if you now open up the Dolby Atmos Composer, let's go back to the master section, we open it up, we already see that Spacelab has been recognized. It is currently set to stereo. Now I actually want to have that fully immersive. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to switch that over to a Dolby Atmos 9.1.6, and that essentially makes sure that the reverb actually comes in as a 9.1.6 signal. And that's pretty much everything I need to do first. And then the second thing really is I need to put the Spacelab Beam plugin onto the group, onto the individual group track. And that will essentially ensure that the signal goes from the group into the Spacelab plugin. Now, there are a couple of things that we need to do. So one thing at a time. So let's first put a Spacelab Beam plugin onto our group. So let's go to our group number one. And the first thing I need to do is, because I need to make sure that the kick is not sent into the Dolby Atmos Composer twice. And for those of you who have seen last week's video, I had to do the same thing in the pure Dolby Atmos Composer setup. We need to make sure that it's not sent in twice. So that means that we need to make sure that the kick signal is not forwarded into the group, because the group is sent separately into the Dolby Atmos Composer. So the way this would work right now is that the kick would go into the Dolby Atmos Composer via the Beam plugin, and then would also be mixed into the group. The group would then be forwarded to Spacelab. Spacelab would then send it into the Dolby Atmos Composer, so we actually get it in twice, and we don't want that. Now, the easiest way to do that is simply to go into the mixer settings, and once again, we did the same thing last week and simply set the gain level to, last week I said 0, but it's actually minus infinity, so let's just set that down to minus infinity. We will still hear the kick, because the kick is not passed through the group, it's actually going directly into the Dolby Atmos Composer, but it will make sure that the kick only goes into the Dolby Atmos Composer once. So the next thing we need to do is we need to route group number one into the Spacelab plugin, and the way to do that is simply by adding, I'm going to go into the group here, and I'm simply going to add a Spacelab Beam plugin. So let's go into Spacelab Beam, so Fiedler Audio, Spacelab Beam. And that essentially Spacelab Beam plugin will be responsible for sending everything into the Spacelab plugin. And from the Spacelab plugin, it will then be forwarded into the Dolby Atmos Composer. Now, a couple of things that you need to do. First of all, for some reason, it comes in with a gain of 12 dB. This is going to be too loud, so I'm going to reduce that to 0. Not quite sure why it comes up that way, but that's fine. We just need to reduce that here. Otherwise, it's going to be too hot. And then the other difference that you might already notice is that in contrast to the Dolby Atmos Beam plugin, so if I go, for example, in the Dolby Atmos Beam plugin in the kick, panning is done within the Beam plugin. In the Spacelab Beam plugin, the panning is actually done. So let's go back to the group here. Is actually not done within the plugin. The panning is actually done within Spacelab. So if I go into the group here, the Spacelab is essentially responsible for changing the position of the individual objects. Now, I just noticed that I put it on the sound level here. That's fine. Now, let's just kind of remove that here. Let's put it into the group instead. So I'm going to put the Beam plug, the Spacelab plugin into the group instead. So here we have Spacelab Interstellar. And then The other thing that I did is, let me just go back into the master section here, into Dolby Atmos Composer. Ah, yeah, it remembered that it's wanted to be 9.1.6, that's fine. So, okay, so now we have the Spacelab Beam plugin set up. We have Spacelab set up as our reverb. We have the Dolby Atmos Composer set up. There's just one thing, actually there are two things that I need to do. The first thing is I need to make sure that the signal actually reaches Spacelab, because in contrast to the Dolby Atmos Composer, within Spacelab, we actually need to tell Spacelab where the Beam plugin is. So it does not recognize that automatically. So if I'm going back into the group settings of this group that just holds the Spacelab Interstellar plugin, I'm going to have to actually explicitly tell Spacelab where that Beam plugin is. And this is done by going into the setup here, to this cogwheel, and I'm going to select the input source. I didn't give it a name. It's just kind of showing up as number one here. And that will then ensure that the Spacelab plugin is actually receiving the signal from that group track. So let's play that. At the moment, we will see we're actually still not hearing any signal, but that it has a particular reason. So let's just play that now. So it is already kind of everything is connected, everything is set up, but we still don't hear anything. And the reason for that is that, and I think that is just the way machine handles empty tracks. We actually need to put the sound into group E, otherwise the machine is not going to, or is going to simply ignore the track. So everything that I need to do is just take a sound, and I'm going to take just this acid tape here. I'm just going to put it here. And if I now play the audio, I should actually hear both the kick as well as the entire group, and the entire group together with the reverb. So let's just play that. So at the moment, everything is already reaching my Dolby Atmos Composer. So once again, if I go back into the Dolby Atmos Composer, I see that here. Now, the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to actually switch that into objects. What that will do is it will separate out the dry signal from the wet signal. So if I'm pressing object here, it will essentially turn the dry signal into separate objects and will just send the wet signal, which is the reverb, into the first 16 channels, into the 9.1.6. So let's just kind of play that again. So everything is coming in exactly the way it's supposed to be. It's still a little hot, so let's just reduce the gain a little. So let's go back into the group here, and we have Spacelab Beam. Let's reduce that further, maybe to -3 dB. And that should actually... So let's go back into the Dolby Atmos Composer. Yeah, now it's fine. Now what we can do is we can go into Spacelab, and in Spacelab, once again, here we have Spacelab Interstellar. We can play around with the reverb. So a couple of things that we can do is we can change how much of the reverb is actually forwarded. We can do that either through the wet gain or through the dry wet knob. We can also change the type of the reverb. And that reverb will then essentially become a 9.1.6 reverb that is forwarded into the Dolby Atmos Composer, and I can now kind of do everything that I did last week with Dolby Atmos, just with this additional immersive reverb. Now, in order to take it one step further, let's add Spacelab plugins, Spacelab Beam plugins to other groups. So let's go through group B, and let's just add a Spacelab plugin here. So we have Abi, Fiedler Audio, Spacelab Beam. And I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to kind of set it to -3 dB. That kind of seemed to have worked. Then I'm going to do the same thing for group number 3, Fiedler Audio, Spacelab Beam. Just check, making sure that the dBs are correct. And then the fourth one. And that essentially makes sure that I have all four groups sent into Spacelab, and all four groups are now going to get a reverb. So for that to work, you now also need to tell Spacelab that I have additional Spacelab Beam plugins in my setup. So let's go back into the group E that holds the Spacelab Interstellar. So let's add three additional groups, or three additional tracks, and let's just kind of add them here. So there's the second one, Then here we have the third one, and I could give them names. I'm just going to leave the names blank here, but you know, kind of in, if you get it to a certain point, obviously it makes sense to add the names so that you have an understanding what is where. And then with that, I should now have all four groups sent into the Dolby Atmos Composer, and I should hear reverbs for all four of those. So let's just play them. And if we go into the master section here and we open up the Dolby Atmos Composer, I now see these four additional, or these three additional groups coming in, and I can turn them into objects. That will essentially make sure that the dry signal is sent into the objects 21 to 26, and the wet signal is sent into the reverb, which essentially is held by the 9.1.6 bed. So what I want to do now is I want to be able to also control that via the machine hardware. And in order to do that, I need to expose the parameters that I want to control, so the position parameters for those objects that I just created. And in the way Spacelab works, this is not as straightforward as with the Dolby Atmos Composer itself. So for example, if I go into the group settings of group E here, for example, in Interstellar, which essentially is the one that is responsible for changing the positions of all those objects, I see that I essentially cannot really control the parameters from within machine because they are not yet exposed to machine. So in order to be able to do that, what I need to add is I need to expose these parameters to machine so that I can control them with the hardware. And this is what we're going to do next. Before I continue, a quick reminder, if you have enjoyed this video so far, please give it a like and subscribe to my channel. If you have any questions or comments, please either use the comment section below or join us on our Discord server. The invite link is in the description. If you want to support this channel, you can do so by becoming a member either through YouTube or Patreon. There's also a free membership option on Patreon. You can also use one of the affiliate links below or buy some of my in-immersion Wefind Presence merch, like this very comfortable pillow, for example. All contributions to this channel are used to purchase the software and hardware I talk about on this channel. And with that being said, let's get back to our Dolby Atmos machine for some automation and side-chaining action. So let's expose our position parameters in Spacelab Interstellar to machine so that we can access them with the machine hardware. Now, this is actually straightforward to do, but we still need to set that up manually simply because, and that's my feeling, that there are just too many parameters. So let's say, for example, you have like 10 tracks that are all routed into Spacelab, and then for each track you have this many parameters. So you need to essentially tell the system which are the ones that you actually want to automate or which are the ones that you want to use with the machine hardware. And this is done by going into Interspace Interstellar, and in the reverb section here we have the automation kind of button. So what we need to do is we need to tell Spacelab which are the parameters that we want to automate, and by kind of telling Spacelab that parameter needs to be automated, we automatically also expose that to machine. So let's go into the automation section here. And I'm just going to do that for one example. You can do that for all the others that you want to automate in the exact same way. So what we're going to do is we're going to add a lane group. And in this lane group, we are going to essentially choose what parameters we want to automate. Now, in general, what you want to automate is the position information, but you can use any of those. So let's just kind of use the position information here. And we have four different tracks, obviously, and the listener. We can also automate the listener position, but what I'm going to do is I'm simply going to take this one. I'm going to add that to the lane group. I'm going to say OK. And then I also need to tell the system, I need to tell the system what the host parameters are. And these host parameters can be any that are exposable. Now we are going to start, obviously, with parameters 1, 2, 3. Doesn't really make any difference. So 1, 2, 3 are the ones. So let's press OK. And this will now expose these parameters to parameters 1 through 3. We can give them a name. It's currently called L1 for the first group left channel. And as soon as I've done that, I should now see these parameters accessible in machine. So if I close Spacelab again, I now see that I have these three parameters here, and I can, when I play that, essentially change the position of those parameters. And if I go into Spacelab Interstellar, I will essentially see how this adjusts the parameters. Now, the way this is set up is that left and right channel are changed together. So that's just the way things are set up here. But this allows you essentially to automate those parameters and to work with the hardware in controlling those parameters, for example, in a live setup. So the last thing I want to do is I want to add a little bit of sidechaining action. And what I want to do is I want to sidechain the reverb signal, so the wet signal only, with the kick. And I can actually do that with the Fiedler Audio Gravitas plugin. Now, this is a paid plugin. You need to purchase that. It doesn't come with either Composer or the Spacelab plugin. It is a separate plugin, but this is a really, really good plugin. I did a couple of videos about it in the past. I'm going to leave some links in the description below where we go through the details. Here, we're just going to use that in order to do the sidechaining action in the Dolby Atmos Composer. Now, one of the nice things about this multi-channel compressor or multi-channel dynamics plugin is that it has the capability to work within the Dolby Atmos Composer on all 128 channels. So it's technically a 128 channel compressor. That's what it is. So how do we do that? Well, first of all, we go into the Dolby Atmos Composer, and then we have here this master channel button. So let's select that. And in the master channel button, in the master channel, what we can do is here, we can add additional plugins that are sort of operating like a master channel in a traditional music production setup. Now, in Dolby Atmos, usually you don't have a master channel. So this is really unique to the Dolby Atmos Composer. And it is something that Fiedler Audio implemented with the development of the Gravitas plugin. But I think it's really an interesting development. What it allows us to do is it allows us to add a master channel to a Dolby Atmos project. Now, the way this is done here is we're simply going to add a module. Currently, there's only one module available, which is this Gravitas module, which is a dynamics processor. Once again, I'm assuming that Fiedler Audio will create additional modules in the future, but that's just a guess. So at the moment, we only have Gravitas, but that's fine. That's all we really need in order to do our sidechaining. So we have added Gravitas here. So let's open up the editor. And once again, I did a number of videos about Gravitas already. I'm going to leave links in the description below. So I'm not going to go through all the details. But what I need to set up and what I want to do is I want to take the kick signal and I want to sidechain the composite, so the first 16 channels. So I need to go into the input selection or input configuration. And here I have the channels that are going to drive the compressor, so the detector channels, the detector input. So I can change them and can kind of decide how much each individual channel is going to contribute to the detector signal. And then I have the input selector, which allows me to select which are the channels that are actually going to be affected by the compression. And by default, these are linked. So if I select or deselect one, then it automatically also deselects the corresponding channel on the detector. But what I actually want to do is I want to use different channels to drive the composite channels. So what I want is I want the kick channels, and those are channels 17 and 18 to drive the first 16, or to drive the compressor on the first 16. So what I'm going to do is in the detector input mixer, I'm going to deselect everything but the channels 17 and 18, because those are once again the two kick channels. And I'm also going to deselect the composite here. Let's just deselect everything. I have to do that manually, unfortunately, but it's something that you only need to do once, so that's fine. And then in the input selector, the channels that I want to actually sidechain is, and this once again is completely up to you. This is a creative decision. In this particular case, for example, I'm only going to sidechain the reverb. So let's just deselect everything but the composite. And that essentially will make sure that the channels 17 and 18 are driving the compressor that is going to operate on channels 1 through 16, which is the composite. So let's play our audio, and then let's play around with the compressor settings here. So I see the kick signal here coming in. Now, one thing that I can do is, now this is a fairly clean kick, but one thing that I could do, for example, I could change the filter to only filter out the low end, so that the compressor is only reacting on the low end, for example. And then I can change, obviously, the threshold. I can change the knee. Now, in order to make that a little bit clearer, what I'm going to do is I'm going to mute the three additional groups that I brought in. This is essentially just going to compress the reverb, and the kick comes through as an object cleanly. Now, in general, you would probably want to deselect auto gain in this particular case, because auto gain is a little bit counterproductive, but it makes a little clearer what's actually happening here. So you really get this pumping action on the reverb. Now, if you want to now automate those parameters, you can do that in exactly the same way as we did for Spacelab. Also in the Dolby Atmos Composer within Gravitas, we have this automation button here. We click on that automation button, and that allows us to select which of the parameters we want to expose to the machine, soft and hardware. So for example, if you want to automate the threshold, we can simply say we want to have that on parameter number 2. And if I do that, I now have within machine that additional button that allows me to control that, and I cannot control that within the machine hardware. And this is a lot of fun. Now, this is super easy to set up. This is extremely creative, and it allows you to work with Dolby Atmos in a machine ecosystem with full immersive reverb, with full immersive dynamics processing, and the possibilities are almost endless. A lot of fun. And that's everything I wanted to say today. Thanks again for watching my videos. I truly appreciate it. If you have any questions or comments, please use the comment section below or join us on our Discord server for a chat. And with that being said, see you all in the next video.